This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. We're going to get ready to start our Sunday morning worship. We have a slow start because it's kind of wet and nasty outside, so we're giving people a chance to swim on in.
Yeah.
I had my dip in the pool.
We give you the honor and we give you the glory. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Anyone who has a testimony, a song of your heart.
on, somebody stand up on your feet and give God a hand clap of praise in this place.
Oh, Thank you.
was holding at me.
what to you, but he's everything to me. In 2015, I am withholding nothing. Amen. Amen. How many of you have joined God the service so far? How many of you ready to go and look at higher in the Lord? Stand to your feet all over the building. If you have feet, if you don't, stand up on your knees or stand up on your feet. As we receive the word of God with the word of God on today, as I present the song and introduce the others, our very own minister, Cynthia. Lord, everybody. God, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for keeping us as we slept last night and waking us up this morning. We pray that everything goes according to your plan and that your will be done. Lord, we thank you for your holy presence in this place. We pray that lives be transformed, Lord. We pray that no one leaves out the same way they came in, Lord. We pray that you continue to have your way. Cover us with your blood, Lord. And we just thank you for all you've done, doing, and about to do in our lives, Lord. And we just bless your name. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Amen. Today's message will be coming from Hebrews 11, verses 1 through 3. When you have it, say amen. While we're waiting, I'll just give a testimony. Give an honor to God, Pastor Ray, Minister Ray, Pastor Ray, to my husband, Minister Bird, all my brothers and sisters in Christ. I just like to thank God for this opportunity to stand before his people, to speak a word in due season of what he's given me to say. And just thanking him for another chance to get it right and to be a blessing to others, praying that my life sometimes that I may inspire someone else. And I ask for y'all to continue to pray my strength in the Lord. Amen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good report. Through faith we understand that the words we were formed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do not appear, which do appear. The title of the message being Determined by Faith.
Right?
In the text, it tells us that faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. We can't buy it, we can't sell it, we can't give it away. So what is faith and what is the role that faith plays in our lives? The dictionary defines faith as belief in devotion to or trust in somebody or something. It also defines faith as belief in devotion to God. The Bible has much hope to say about faith, and it's so important that it says that it's impossible to please God without it. We even have no place with God if we don't have faith. If you're facing a test in faith, you too must move forward based on God's character and his unfailing promises. Relying on God will help you move from place to place and it'll take you to where he wants you to go. God knows us inside and out. No situation is too big for him. We're always quick to forget his grace and his mercy. It's one thing to make a promise. It's another to have the power to keep the promise. The children of God have confidence in God's power to do everything he has promised us to do. He has the power to do anything we ask him to do. When it comes to faith in God, we must always remember that he is and he has an eternal plan for each and every one of us that he's working out for our good. He will not do anything that is outside of his plan. He will do everything we ask just because he won't do everything we ask just because we ask him, because he wants us to build faith. If he gives us everything that we want when we want it, that's not building faith. That's not a good thing. So we have to go through things to get what we want. He will do those things that he wills to do, and he will accomplish our things. Faith in God and the promises found in his word allows us to believe God in the most impossible situations of life. When you have a death of a loved one, tragic accident, job loss, heartbreak, sickness, whatever it is that you may go through, you're going to have faith when you can endure these things. The situation comes to build the trust. In Proverbs 3:5-7, it also says, trust in the Lord, lean not into your own understanding, but acknowledge him in all your ways, and allow him to direct your path. If you trust in him, he can cover everything. The love of God covers a multitude of sins. He can give us what we ask for, but if you don't activate the faith that he gives you, how can you do it? Faith without works is dead. How can you pray and say, okay, God, I'm trusting you and I'm believing you to do this, and as soon as you walk out the door, God, I hope you do it, please. And you go back and take everything that you've given him or that you've asked him to do. God gives us time, gives us help in our present time. He also gives us confidence to know in his word that no matter what, his scripture is true. Every word of the Bible is true. Everything that he inspired through the prophets is true. So why don't we believe it, or why don't we have faith? We have little faith. And he says, as long as you have enough faith of a mustard seed, y'all know a mustard seed is real small. If you have just that little bit, he can do the rest, but you have to trust him with even that. We don't even want to trust him with our finances. Finances, with our relationships, with our jobs, or anything else, we try to work everything out on our own. If he wanted that, he wouldn't have said, lean not into your own understanding. He tells us to trust him in every area of our lives, but we still want to do things the way we want to do them, not trusting him, knowing that he created us. He knows everything about us anyway, so y'all need to listen up. We're always trying to work things out on our own, and that's not going to work. We have believed by faith, and it's already in our lives, that you just can't, just because you can't see it doesn't mean that it's not working out. Thank God for the power of faith. It is by faith that we can overcome, by trusting in the Lord. God has confirmed his promises in our heart, and he's just waiting on us. You know, he's working it out, he's waiting on us, and he's going to fulfill it in his time, not our time. Some may not believe, but God has assured you through faith. Trust him, hold on to his promises. And his time, he will bring it to pass. Bringing it to pass may not be the day, it may not be tomorrow, whenever it is. And it may not come the way that you want it to come. The blessing always come in different ways. Small, like we say, blessings come in little disguises. It may come through a child, it may be a spoken word. You may be looking for a big payoff. Somebody might be waiting on I was talking to cousin-in-law, he was waiting on a settlement to come in. I told him, you waiting on a big blessing from God, but the big blessing might not be a lump sum. It might be you getting a job, whether it's making minimum wage or not. Yeah. God say, I will supply all of your needs, support you, and reach you to do what you quite good. It has nothing to do with the way we want it. We want the big blessing, but like I've always said before, we want the blessing, but we don't want to go through the battle to get it. In James 1:3-4, I believe it says, the trying of our faith worketh patience. If you meditate on the word, the Bible study lesson was totally for me. Everything she said, God has spoken out to me. I even showed her the paper after the church to let her know, how did you do that? That's God. So, and I'm like, God, just come. I'm always looking for a sign and want confirmation. And he said, how much more confirmation can you need? So he confirmed it, that we can't live without faith. Apart from faith and apart from God, we can't have nothing, we can't do anything. You have to activate your faith. If you want the job, go in, claim it, believe it, and receive it. And if it's for you, he's going to give it to you. Amen. Whatever it is that you want, you must stand on the word of God, no matter what. Meditate on it day and night. Like I told y'all before, most of y'all get scriptures from me. Don't just read that one scripture. Read the whole chapter. Activate it. Cover yourself with the blood. He said we perish for lack of knowledge. Yeah, you got them on. If anything, we even got a cell phone. Y'all can read it. Y'all pick up that phone and go on Facebook instead of gossiping, quoting scriptures. Yeah. Let people read it. But God has a plan designed for each and every one of us. Pastors told y'all over and over, every person that gets up here said that, and they know that this is a church filled with prophets, ministers, teachers, preachers, everything. Everyone in this place has a calling on their life. What are you going to do? You going to step out of faith, step out on faith to do what he's called to do? Or you going to sit and wait for everybody else to get elevated?
All right.
Wow. Say, if you don't step up, he's going to call somebody else to do it. I'd rather just stand up, whether I deny my flesh every day to do it. And each one of y'all needs to get on your job, get on your post, because pastor and every leader in the church need y'all, because the enemy is out that door waiting to get in.
And if everybody is not equipped and filled with the full armor of covering yourself with the blood of Jesus, he'll bring them right on in. Speak a word in due season of what thus say the Lord. Be a blessing to us. Let your light shine to inspire others. Because we are all frontline soldiers and we are one for God. It's only what you do for God that will last. No matter what. When you see people that get under your skin and make your nerves bad, pray for them. Like that's say, hurting people hurt people. You don't know what's going on with these people. Pray for them. Pray for them. You want to say ugly words, tell God, take captive of my thoughts and bite my tongue as I sit against you. Laugh about it. My husband would always joke me, talking, just cover with the blood and wait until you go to the head. That's right. I didn't want to say some evil stuff. And I wake up and I be sore because I be fighting with that war with my flesh and my spirit. I be sore because I be wanting to say some stuff because my mouth was real foul. Even though I don't curse no more, my thoughts still sometimes like that. I've always been bold. This didn't just happen. What you see is what you get. The way I am is where I am at home. But I just thank God for being
the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe.